Look, when I'm at the gas station, this ain't no Christian mingle. This ain't farmers only. This ain't no dating site. I'm in and out. Please don't. Please don't. Please don't try to. Can I get you? I'm gonna get you Snapchat.
Number one fear of men: rejection. And you're gonna make a video making fun of him for trying his best to show interest in you.
So, after watching this video in which a young, let's not kid ourselves, really attractive woman was making a TikTok after a bad experience she had with a man that tried to approach her and flirt with her at a gas station. The man whose TikTok we are watching is Coach gregdoucette, a seasoned bodybuilder with great videos around his area of expertise. I totally recommend you to check his advice on fitness related stuff. However, in this TikTok, he tried to confront this woman about her behavior and her lack of empathy toward this man that only tried to approach her, suggesting that actions similar to this only make worse the already existing fear of rejection in men. This video was deemed controversial, with many accusing Coach Greg of misogyny and others of the young woman for being narcissistic and inconsiderate. Let's give an answer from a psychological standpoint to the debate. After watching carefully, two questions came to my mind. How the duck do the two people with the most annoying voice participate in the same TikTok? And the most notable one, should men openly be able to flirt with women whenever and wherever? In this video, we are going to talk a bit about the latter. If you haven't already come to the conclusion, I'm a man. So, it's only fair to start the argument from a woman's point of view and try to understand their feelings first. Firstly, every woman, from average looking to absolutely gorgeous, receives thousands of compliments and a great bunch of attention during their lifetime. This fact alone makes men's attention, and more specifically direct attention, not so significant for women. If you are a woman nowadays, getting approached by men has happened many times in the past. So, if the man that makes the move is not something special, they get treated like an annoying routine. Something that they know it is happening to them, but would rather avoid at all costs. Secondly, there is a certain level of fear that women experience when they are getting approached by random men that should be totally respected. There have been many incidents when men didn't have boundaries and acted with violence toward women that rejected them. There is a saying among women that says, men's fear is rejection, while women's fear is the reaction of the rejected man. Indeed, women are really afraid when approached by strangers, especially in an outdoor environment. Having said all that, you can easily understand the raw reality. Except for attractive men, women really do despise getting approached, and they think that is definitely an annoying habit of men. Some women also go as far as characterizing men who are openly flirting as perverts or creepy guys that can't control themselves. Now, let's get to a man's point of view, and start with the basic but shocking fact that 44% of that 60% of single men report that they avoid talking to women out of fear of being labeled as creepy. And that is a shocking find, because you can see the desperation of men and the criminalization of a natural source of connecting with one another, which is flirting. Flirting occurs everywhere in nature and is highly important for both the reproduction of our species and the socialization between the two genders. It is critical to continue the relationship between the two genders, as cutting the edges with unnecessarily harsh opinions from both parties is producing more harm than good, such as violence between the two genders. For a man, flirting and romantically approaching a woman is their only chance to meet someone they like, meaning that they do not get the attention and the chances they have, and being able to approach them is a gift for them in order to getting a chance to know them. The first fear of men, as every human on planet Earth, is not rejection, but death. However, the already hammered and battered self-esteem of men that's a result of social media only worsens when women mistreat them and ridicule them publicly when trying to approach them. The statistic I demonstrated to you speaks for itself. 44% of men are single because they are afraid that they will be embarrassed by women. women's fear should be absolutely respected by every man who has some level of empathy and intelligence. Skills that every guy who wants to be in a relationship should possess. However, some modern movements have exaggerated that fear, making it impossible for a man to make the first move without being accused of being a pervert. The agenda that is pushed forward by those movements is close to saying, let's stop walking down the street or going for a jog because there have been incidents when people were assassinated. When you think of this, it sounds irrational, a doubt of order, but it's the same as saying, let's stop flirting because some men have followed women because they can't take no for an answer, which is true, but at the same time, often discussed. What no one takes into account is the percentage of men that feels that will end up alone because they are afraid that a woman will embarrass them and or will make them feel afraid. Those men need help, and TikToks like this only amplify the chances of this percentage going up and up. What women should say to men is not, stop approaching us, you are creeping us out, but learn how to approach us nicely to make us feel safe, as the chances of us liking you this way already increases. Psychologically, you can't shame someone for being afraid, but you can shame people that proceed to criminal actions because their ego got hurt by a woman. So, as men, we should not be against women who are afraid of us while approaching them. That can't be rapidly changed, but we should be vivid and lively against other men who have created this fear, and of course, women who try to capitalize on that. And believe me, there are many that do this. They try to make it seem like all men are ego monsters who want to hurt women if they don't do their willing. I can reassure you that it's not the case, as most men are only discouraged because they don't want you to feel negative emotions such as stress, fear, panic, and anxiety. Women need to understand that, read people, and give the chance to benevolent ones to come closer to them, letting them know them, but also it is a man's absolute duty to shame other men who mistreat women, as this only opens a vicious circle that will devour everyone and everything. Learn, think, adapt, and change. Till the next one, that was my opinion, I got just psychology, and I'm out.